Hey, I've been going like crazy the past couple days. I forgot to put the video up last week because I was having so much fun flying. You know, I'm becoming like an FPV wizard. You know, like, did I just make myself disappear again? I hate when I do that. You should never give that much power to someone like me who would irresponsibly use it or just mess up all the time. Look at the Joker, right? Is that the coolest canopy ever? This came from Catalyst Machine Works. They used to hate that old one because it was so hard to work with, but this one, so much easier and so much cooler looking. Look at that. Want to see it fly? Okay. Now, for those of you that don't follow my Instagram, which you should, links down below, just follow me. Put a lot of videos up there. Look at the Batman now. So I modified the Batman, lowered the top here down from 35 millimeters down to 20 millimeters or 25, I think it was 20. 20 millimeters. Not lighting up the bat signal anymore, but it still looks cool. So that's great. But that's not the point of this video, man. Yes, it's true. I have made the jump to Crossfire. Why did I go to Crossfire? Well, a couple of reasons. But I'm just not gonna tell you what they are. I did it because I wanted to. You thought there was gonna be some kind of knowledge transfer going on here. Why do you people keep thinking someday I'm gonna get smarter? I made the jump to Crossfire on everything except one aircraft, because Herbert is really like a test aircraft, so it doesn't really need it. Maybe eventually I'll do it, but everything from Bumblebee on up to Bluebird 1 got Crossfire. So I initially had some trouble with Crossfire, and I'll show you the video first and then we'll talk about it. So here we go. Unbeknownst to me, when I purchased my Crossfire TX transmitter, TX that plugs into the back of the Tyrannus, somehow the U.FL connector for that antenna came off. And I could not figure out why what was happening that you just saw was happening. It drove me crazy. And I'm like, well, it can't be Crossfire. I put everything in correctly. And It's gotta be something else. So I contacted TBS through email and I said, hey, your product, man, what's the deal? It's not working. What do you want me to do? And they were all like, hey, why don't you crack that transmitter open? And I was like, I don't wanna void my warranty, no. And they were like, you know what? If we tell you to open up the back of your transmitter, don't worry about it. You're not gonna void your warranty. Let's just go take a look at that. And sure enough, U.FL, which I hate U.FL antennas because they always snap off or, you know, just pop off their connection. There it was, off its connection. So I had planned for this video to be last weekend, but because of all of that, and you know, you have to be careful you don't void warranty. So I didn't want to go in and just investigate myself and then find out, well, actually I did open it up before I called them, so I just didn't take it fully apart. But it's fixed, and now I'll tell you the truth, I can't live without Crossfire now. I find, and we're going to do a little bit of comparison, I don't know if you see it really good, but on Bumblebee, which is sitting right over here, I figured Bumblebee, because of its size and the way it handles and because of propellers and blah, 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 would be the best demonstrator of the difference between Free Sky and Crossfire. Before we get into that comparison, what you'll be looking for is the way the aircraft turns now with Crossfire versus Free Sky on a side-by-side comparison. What I've always felt, and I always didn't know, you know, what it was, maybe it was PID tuning or not, but there appears to have been some latency that I was not aware of in the Free Sky stuff versus Crossfire. I would always kind of, when I made a turn, you would think, oh, well, you want to fix your PIDs if you're going to be sliding across in your turn. And I used to say, no, it's not that. It's got to be something else. And sure enough, I really feel like it was because there was some delay in Free Sky versus now when you look at the video, watch the Crossfire, which should be on your left-hand side, and Free Sky is on the right-hand side, and watch how it turns as you come into banking and all that stuff on it. I feel like there's so much more control on it. Now, had I not had the initial problem with the antenna being disconnected, you know, we probably would have got to this sooner, but we're getting to it now. And I'm not going to go through a full install. It's pretty easy. There is one thing I am going to tell you, though. There have been a lot of videos made looking at the old Nano, Team Black Sheep Nano. There is a difference between the two that you really, really should take note of before you start looking at other people's videos. I'll put a graphic up here. There are two versions we're talking about. The one on the left is version 4.22. The one on the right is the version 4.23, which is the one I have. So when I went looking around for install videos, I was watching some of the wires go connected, and then I went immediately to TBS first, and I noticed this little difference, whereas the reviewer, through no fault of their own, was saying, okay, this is how the wires get connected. And now you, a person now in the living in the now, like the right now, you bought a 4.23 and you're like looking at the video going, wait a minute, that doesn't seem right. Or you hooked it up and poof, there goes your Nano. So always be careful, you know, even with my videos or anyone else's videos, you know, there's no way to update them to insert something and say, hey, something changed. You know, it's just, it sits out there in infamy. You know, someday an alien race will come down and see my videos and go, phew. Wow, glad we wiped out that race of evil. So while this is a short video, we do get some flying to do. So let's charge them up, line them up, rev them up, let's go fly! So again, there you go. Crossfire, I'm all in. Now it's just rapid fire I gotta wait for. But I love this. I feel like it is so much more fun to fly on each one of the aircraft. That it's just incredible, the difference. Some people have said that, you know, Free Sky may have as much as a 10 millisecond delay, which, you know, some people, 10 milliseconds, wow, you know, I could do this and 10 milliseconds beat me. No, so now I beat it, haha. But in flying time, 10 milliseconds is like a lifetime. Okay, not really a lifetime, but, you know, it's a turn, or it's a flip, or it's a, you know, alley-oop. If you know how to do an alley-oop, I don't. Don't ask me how to do an alley-oop, I don't know. And so I highly, highly recommend you get the Crossfire. People will tell you there are certain ways to put the antenna on. As far as I'm concerned, I am looking for protection of the antenna. And say on this model, I like it this way because nothing can really hit it. And I'll just turn my antenna on the transmitter a different way. Also on this model, I've done the same thing. Bumblebee has the default antenna that comes with the Nano when you buy it. It's just largely two wires, so I've wrapped it around like I would normally do, as I've done with the other Free Sky ones, where you see the two yellow zip ties with a heat shrink on them. You know, works good. I don't care. We have got a lot of things coming up. I have one race that I went to on Saturday that I have footage for. I have to edit along. It was alongside this one, but I want to get this one out first. It was FPV 863 FPV Addiction had a race in a hangar, which was pretty cool. The footage isn't that great from the DVR, but we'll make do with what we got. It was a fun race. So that should be up, I want to say Wednesday would probably be the only day it would get up there. I'm actually re-recording this one because I was having so much fun, I kept on forgetting to turn the camera on again. I know, sucking at this, aren't I? So, from the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida, this is Mighty Thor. Go out and get yourself a Crossfire. I highly recommend it. See ya!